Building a business or crafting a brand, it's always been part art and part science. And today, with technology playing such a crucial role, the business of marketing itself is undergoing a tectonic shift. I'm Aditya Save, co-founder of Agilio Labs, and I've spent the last two decades at the intersection of brands and technology. Together with Bloomberg Quint Brand Studios and Adohm, in this season of Brandsmiths, I talk to some of the best marketing practitioners in the country, and I try and get their perspective on this era of technology dominated by artificial intelligence.
Power your marketing campaigns with artificial intelligence and engage your consumers using predictive recommendations across all digital media. Build one-to-one customer journeys and map it across multiple touch points. Integrated CRM to increase your ROI and enhance your brand. A smart customer intelligence system which powers and personalizes your omni-channel marketing efforts.
Hello and welcome to another exciting episode of Brandsmiths. Today on my panel, I have Rohit M.A. from Cloud9 and I have Kuldeep Chaudhary from Adohm. Together, we're going to try and deep dive into the healthcare category and try and understand what are the growth drivers for this category in India. What are the challenges that marketing and technology together can face and probably can solve? What do you think are the key challenges for the category as a whole?
If you look at India as a country, the metrics have always been skewed. So there is about 1,700 patients who get access to one doctor, right? So it is a really uphill battle. It becomes a particular challenge about how does one access healthcare, and that is where, right from the government to private players, I think there is a lot of excitement about how technology can play a role in being able to bridge this gap.
So within this ecosystem, how does Cloud9 see itself?
We are India's largest maternity and childcare providers. So for us, we have the unique ability to attract a new kind of population, right? So these are people who've not necessarily been acquainted with healthcare system in general.
Your customers are largely healthy, tech savvy, and then obviously given the situation, they are very, very highly involved.
Yeah.
What are some of your marketing challenges in this then?
We believe that our customer base are the millennials, right? So typically, if you ask any campaign manager, they would say the top big social media networks are, A, B, C, and D. But you really miss out on how the millennials are actually consuming information. For us, what that means is, we are constantly experimenting, and our CPL and CPC may not be as immediate as what healthcare metrics may stand today.
Kuldeep, I want to understand from a diverse category perspective.
Yeah.
He mentioned his numbers both in terms of CPC and CPL.
Correct.
Right? But this is a category where there is a predefined period, almost a natural period in which they have involvement or interest in his offering.
Yeah.
And the fact that before and after that, they will sort of move away from the category.
Correct.
So what do you think are the challenges that they face, and which of those challenges can technology solve?
Today, what you can advertise on particular subjects, you might not be able to do this after 2 months or 3 months if the government brings some kind of a law, because it's a very restricted area and policies.
Sure.
So you have to be very sure what you are advertising. So most of these millennials who are tech savvy, they basically search or do online research. So the trimester wise, you can target the audience with a similar kind of pattern. When they approach, they also are aware that Cloud9 knows you. If you are in your first trimester, it's not always your ads and services. It's also about the care and tips. They are actually always looking hunt for information. So the customer attraction can be more with personalizations.
Rohit, I just wanted to understand from your perspective, how do you balance offline and online marketing in your category?
Typically what we've done is, when we have large announcements to make, we do use offline opportunities to communicate that. So the offline opportunities vary from the typical newspapers to radio to precise neighborhood marketing, all the various means of outdoor engagements. It becomes very difficult to try and ascertain a metric towards some of these things. You will have the kick of probably having put a front page ad, but if it reflected into 100 people coming and using your service, probably not quantifiable as much as what online can do. We've increasingly started moving into the online part of it, as against typically sticking to offline. So we usually start with offline. where we announce, and then entire engagement largely shifts into a online kind of engagement.
Is your technology deployment equally high?
When I talk to you about ROI, how do I know this is because, you know, as soon as a lead is qualified, be it on our website, any of our engagement channels, this immediately launches into a pipeline, right? So we know an actual engagement score that we have with the individual patient or, you know, anybody who searched for us, as to understanding what is their level of discussion with us. Have they come and visited a unit? Have they spoken to someone? Have they, browsed some of our other partner websites? This becomes very, very useful information in qualifying what is the engagement score that we have with them.
Kuldeep, you mentioned customer experience management, right? Especially using technology.
Correct.
Given the fact that there's only a finite cycle in which that customer is available to them.
Correct.
Can you give us some examples of from an AI perspective?
If you are, generating a lot of online content, which is specifically information, which is required for these millennials, we need to basically show our specializations, that what is the content you want to see, and how do you target this audience at semester by semester, month by month, week by week, what information I need to have in this 6 month, what are the precautions I'm looking forward for, why I need to visit a doctor, right?
Interesting.
So these things I do not want to show my 6th week information to somebody who is in the 9th month.
Tech seems to almost seep into functions, into companies, into industries, right? So if you just look at the last 5 or 10 years almost now, how has technology moved into your marketing team?
Right. So I think for us, we largely classify it into 3 buckets. Okay, so we actually call it the 3D. So it's basically discovery, diagnosis, and decision making, right? So we've always looked at technology which can help us across all these three. It can either be seamless across all these three functions or individual to those particular ones, right? So from decision making, it can be that, you know, how does one decide to actually consume a service? Or if they've consumed a service, are they going to continue with us, right? So these are all, you know, ways and means of extracting data. Now, across all of these three spheres, Aditya, is, you know, whatever we can actually employ as AI or ML, right? Now, what is AI? AI is basically saying that, look, there is a limited computing ability of the human brain. Now, if I make it unlimited, then that intelligence becomes, you know, artificial in a way, right? But the data is real. Now, unless we build data, there is nothing to learn off as intelligence and do a decision,
sure,
right?
Completely agree with you.
So that is, for a provider like us, you know, that is all that we are trying to do.
Kuldeep, do you see some of these businesses trying to battle between efficiency and effectiveness?
But there is no AI who can find out if they are good leads or not. And every human person has to call them, convince them, tell about your brand, that why you have inquired, this and that. So if you give a personalization to the technology side, the efficiency, I think we have seen it increase in multiple stages from multiple client sides as well.
In a category like this, where you are, there's a lot of empathy, there are consumers who are going through a certain high involvement, high emotion period in their life. How do you actually look at ROI? How many perspectives do you use for looking at ROI?
You know, one is, for us, it was about effective utilization of our resources, be it manpower, be it, the actual time that somebody is spending on a particular query, right? So one big metric was for entirely the efficiency. The other is just the cost of some of these things, right? Now, for example, we've had X number of telephone lines of this order, which will be available to you. And, you know, each call costs us, right? Because there's redirection happening, somebody is picking it up. And now, you know, we're telling everyone that you don't even need to call us anymore, right? Now, we are not trying to change the mindset of people, but we're just trying to change how mindset within the company works. And that's a huge change.
In the next 12 months, okay, where do you see artificial intelligence playing a bigger role in healthcare?
Overall, in healthcare, AI would be playing a big role in terms of, I would say, I'm talking about the implementation medical side, but also in the marketing side. It would be, as I explained it earlier, personalization is the key, what people are looking actually for. Medical term is a really big term. Anybody can have from ankle sprain to a heart condition, they are looking for that precise information. Mm-hmm. If you are not providing that to that person, he's going to the competition.
So anyway. Personalization.
Personalization has to be there. Yeah.
Look, I think more than individual healthcare providers, I think the macro environment plays a huge role. Now, if the government doesn't step in and tell us all to like start generating data in one format, there's absolutely no use of all of us generating this data and looking at it ourselves, right? So I think this will play a huge role. And again, I think where do I see AI and ML having a huge impact? It's across, you know, the same 3 Ds, right? Discovery, diagnosis, and decision making. So from a consumer point of view, as well as medical point of view, that, you know, it's going to have a huge impact across all these three.
As you can see, it's a massive category which depends on some amount of government intervention, some amount of private leadership. Access and trust are two things that everybody is chasing. But if you noticed from both my panelists' conversation, this is a category that has at its core the strategy of TLC, which is Tender Loving Care, and of all things, it competes with Dr. Google. So thank you so much for your time. It's been a really nice conversation, and thank you for watching us. Hope to see you again very soon.